Ladies and gentlemen, let us start the next session. The category is e-inclusion and participation. Let me give you a brief outline about the category, e-inclusion and participation. Measures supporting integration of global information society, bringing disadvantaged community groups into the knowledge society, reducing digital divide between technology-empowered and technology-excluded communities and groups such as women, those in remote rural areas, bringing society and strengthening social and political participation of individuals and groups through ICTs. So that is the broader outline of this category. And today, we have three presenters to present their products under this category. But before that, I will take this opportunity to invite our guest of honor to the front row. Let me give you a brief introduction about him. He is a professor at the Department of Economics and currently functions as the Dean in the Faculty of Graduate Studies of University of Colombo. He has worked extensively on industry and trade policy, small and medium scale enterprises, environmental economics, territory education, and labor market in Sri Lanka, Maldives, Pakistan, Vietnam, and Mongolia. He has been a consultant to the World Bank, Asian Development Bank, International Labor Organization, and advised government agencies in both Sri Lanka and overseas. I take this opportunity to invite Professor Sunil Chandrasiri to the first row as the guest of honor. Thank you, sir. So without further ado, let me invite our first presenter presenting the product, Smart Cyber Asset.
Good morning, everyone. I am Sitara, and I am with the Smart Cyber Asset development team. We are from the Sri Lanka Institute of Information Technology. First of all, we are very happy to present our product to you. We are calling this Smart Cyber Assist. It is a speech recognition and remote PC controlling system. When we consider the today's world population, there are 0.02% of people are differently abled people. In that category, there are 0.001% of people are incapable of using their limbs. There are many existing products out there which made to help those people, but most of those products are not very much reliable and efficient. But our system, it mainly operates on voice recognition and provide many features and facilities for those users. And also, Smart Cyber Assist consists with four different remote access mechanisms: Android application, micro website, Skype, and SMS. We can use all those features to perform the remote access to a PC. With this system, we mainly focus in on three user groups: people who are differently abled, people who are having low IT literacy, and finally people who are in remote locations. Now let's talk about what are the problems that each user group is facing. As all of us know, computers are highly inaccessible for the differently abled people. They can't type a document, they can't send an email, at least they can't listen to a music with using a computer. And also there are many other people who are having low IT literacy. Those people can use computers, but they don't have enough knowledge to do that because of their less or no knowledge of IT. Finally, we are giving the priority for the people who are in remote locations. Being human beings, we all have tendency of forgetting many important things. Let's assume you came to your office and you forget to get a very important file which your boss requested, and it is in your home PC. You don't have any other way to get it back to your office, then there can be a serious problem. And most of the people are forced to carry their laptops when they are traveling. Then it is an additional burden for them. To give a proper solution to those problems, we are introducing you to Smart Cyber Assist. Now let's talk about what are the features of Smart Cyber Assist. Normally when we are using computers, we need to use mouse and keyboard to give instruction to the computer. That is the traditional way of interacting with the computer. But with our system, you can give instructions to the computer just using your voice. Users can control the functions. Users can control the basic functions of Windows operating system, such as create a new folder, open start menu, open my computer, like basic things. We can just use in voice, and also we can just advanced operations like create users and user groups and open registry editors likewise. And also Smart Sybase allows to create full formatted Word documents just using voice. Users can perform basic operations like type a paragraph, type a paragraph and add in basic operations like bold, italic and underline like things. And also users can perform the advanced operations in Microsoft Word, like add in page layouts, page borders and page numbers. And all these things we can done just using our voice. Instead of those features from Smart Sybase, users can control the functions of other softwares like media players, web browsers, and emails. Likewise, we created this software. We developed this software mainly for the Sri Lankan people. And from this software, it gives the response in three different languages. Those three different languages are the mostly used language in Sri Lanka: Sinhala, Tamil, and English. And as I told you earlier, Smart Sybase consists with four different remote access mechanisms: Android application, micro website, Skype, and finally SMS. Nowadays, most of the people are using Android devices. Using our Android application, you can turn on your PC from any remote location and go through the file system of the PC from the Android application, and you can download any required file to your Android application. And the second one is the micro website. Micro website also you can use to access your PC from any remote location through the web. Just type in the URL in the web browser, you can get the file system of your PC from the micro website. Then you just need to go through the file system and you can download required file. The next important one is the Skype. We all know what is the Skype. Skype we mainly use for the video conversations. But with our system, you can use Skype to access your PC remotely and get your files. The final remote feature is the one SMS. We can access our PC remotely from SMS. Just using a normal phone, we can get the service from this feature. Just send in SMS, we can control PC remotely and get your files from your home PC to your email. When it comes to the business plan, first we are planning to release our beta version, and we are planning to market our product through our website and also from the social media also. And after that, given the beta version, we are getting some feedbacks from the users, and based on their feedbacks, we are going to do the further development. Very importantly, this Smart Sybase product is coming to the market as three versions: basic one, professional, and premium one. Basic one only includes the speech recognition features. Professional one includes the speech recognition plus remote access features. Premium one is the full package. It includes all the speech recognition and remote access features. Let's move to the marketability. Now let's talk about marketability of Smart Sybase. If we compare our system with other existing systems which in market, our system have a low product, and it is very easy to use because of its user friendliness. Most importantly, this Smart Sybase application provide many features to the user. Therefore, users can get many services from this application. And very importantly, it's not only covers one area, it covers a huge domain. Therefore, users can get many services from this application. And also, For the business management things also, this application is very suitable. I mentioned we are mainly focusing on three user groups, but instead of those three user groups, normal general users also can get many services from our application to make their day-to-day works more easier. And thank you.